Hello. This is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com talking with you today about the subject of a unified universe of entangled diamonds and altruistic rats. Now, these things might seem very different, and actually they are different, but there are some similarities and something that we can learn from experiments in both of these fields. In the last couple of months, researchers at the University of Oxford in England have shown that they can send pulsed laser zaps to one diamond, which is separated by a physical distance of about half a foot or 6 inches from another very small diamond. And the diamond that's not being zapped actually changes its vibrations instantaneously at the same time as its companion diamond is being zapped with the lasers. Now, what's so remarkable about this is that it is one of the first experiments that seems to be showing that we are seeing some of the same kinds of quantum weirdness, for want of a better expression, that we often see in the quantum world on the scale of the observable, physically tangible world where we can measure things and hold them in our hands and touch and see and taste and smell things. So these very tiny diamonds are something that we can actually look at, and when we observe that they are, one of them is vibrating very differently based on something that didn't even happen to it, but to its companion, then the implications are quite profound. So this is the beginning of starting to see some of the things that we've seen in quantum world, such as this is quantum entanglement. Other things that happen in the quantum world would be things like quantum tunneling, and also the other kind of spooky action at a distance would involve quantum teleportation. So these are the sorts of things we don't normally expect to see in the macro scale world, but nonetheless, there it is. So it's opening up a whole new world for us at this time. Another wonderfully exciting experiment happened over at the University of Chicago involving rats, and this experiment involved researchers wondering if one rat would free another rat from a cage and go to the trouble to figure out how to open the locking mechanism and release the rat. As it turns out, rats are apparently quite altruistic, and they will learn how to open a cage that they've never before learned how to operate. They'll do this for a caged rat to release that rat. They will not do the same thing if there's an empty cage or a cage containing a stuffed toy that looks like a rat but isn't a rat. So this is clearly evident of something going on with the rats and their interest in helping another animal escape something that seems painful or difficult for it. The experimenters further concluded and were able to see conclusive evidence of rats choosing to rescue another rat even when there's a chocolate treat in a separate cage. So it's about a 50-50 thing whether the rat would choose to first access the chocolate treat or free another rat. But even if they did access the chocolate treat first, they usually share that treat with the rat that they then subsequently release from the adjacent cage. So what does this all mean for us, and how does all of this connect? That's what I'm so excited about. To me, these very seemingly different experimental studies and results are showing that we have a universe in which we are all as one. And whether we look at behavioral sciences in psychology or whether we look at physics, we're starting to see experimental evidence that we are not all alone, that we actually do share a commonality of vibration with others. And on a personal level, what this means for each one of us is that we are not alone, that there is someone out there that really cares, that is there for us. Maybe you haven't met them yet, but they do exist. And on a global scale, it means that we are all as one, and our sense of responsibility and our involvement in the universe is expanding as our imagination and our ability to envision a better world also expands. What this really excites me about is that when we ask my favorite question, how good can it get, we're getting to a point when we can start envisioning a much greater possibility for all of us than we've ever previously imagined or been able to imagine before. So until next time, keep asking, how good can it get? And this is Cynthia Sue Larson with realityshifters.com.